I would like to invite Toastmaster Suranga to deliver his fourth speech on CC Network.
Their 1996 Cricket World Cup campaign, a new form 42, pinch hitting openers. Their game plan throughout the tournament revolved around the blazing opening stand. And it was no different for the semi-final game against India played in Calcutta. But to their horror, their two trump cards, Sanath and Kalu, both got out in the very first over of the match. Thousands and thousands of Indian fans started dancing in the streets of Calcutta. Why not? Their path to the World Cup final is not even clear. Meanwhile, in the neighboring country, 20 million Sri Lankans were in deep shock. They pinched themselves hard in disbelief, hoping to wake up from this nightmare. There was a pin drop silence throughout the country, and only silence prevailed. Just profound disappointment, only silence could convey. Sri Lanka's well-laid game plans are in total disarray. Analytical thinking was the need of the hour. Toastmasters and distinguished guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Horses and cows would just go where they are led to. But humans are expected to be more intelligent. They're supposed to think beyond the obvious and take quick and intelligent decisions depending on the demands of the It is for that they are given something called an analytical mind. Today, I want to stress the importance of analytical thinking or using your analytical mind. And to do that, being a cricketer myself, I see no better example than the story I will share with you today. Where quick and intelligent decisions provoked by analytical thinking brought immense glory to our motherland. Toastmasters, join me to relive the glorious memory once more. Sri Lanka's two master blasters have had a rare failure. Someone had to do something to resurrect them. A quick decision was needed. And that man, to be using his analytical mind at that moment, on that day, happened to be Aravind the Reserva. Aravind walked to the river. He assessed the situation and took a quick decision. The brave decision to counter-attack. What unfolded within the next hour was breathtaking and magical. Aravind played delightful cricket strokes one after another. His strokes were placed with so much precision that fielders were rendered redundant. Aravind scored a half century at maniac pace. And thanks to his phenomenal aggression, Sri Lanka managed to pile up a competitive 251 on the score. Betting first and putting up a big score was always the game plan. But it is only half the job done. The next item in the plan was to get some Indian batsmen out pretty quickly and put them under pressure. But that too was not going according to plan. Chasing 252 victory, India were cruising to their target. Two cars were motoring them along. Sachin Tendulkar and Sanjay Manjrekar. 1.6 billion Indian fans started to sense the smell of silver, the refreshing smell of a brand new World Cup. Meanwhile, in the neighboring country, World Cup hopes of 20 million Sri Lankans were starting to evaporate even under the night sky. Someone had to think quickly and do something to stop this transferring. And this time, it was Arjuna. Arjuna's keen eyes noticed a rough patch in the pitch created by the bowler's footmarks. Aravind took Arjuna took a quick decision. Toastmasters, the second quick and intelligent decision taken by a Sri Lankan on the 13th day of March 1996. Arjuna threw the bowl to Sanat Jayasurya and asked Sanat to bowl to that rough. Sanat obliged. Arjuna was right. The rough offered Sanat vicious turn and bows. Two balls later, Sachin was stumped. Manjreka and the next batsman, Ajay Jadeja, were bowled off the rough. And that opened the floodgates. India started to crumble like a pack of cards. They lost 7 wickets for 22 runs in the blink of an eye. From being in a commanding 98 for 1, India collapsed to a fatal 120 for 8. Sri Lanka stormed into the 1996 Cricket World Cup final, beating India. Meanwhile, in the neighboring country, the same 20 million Sri Lankans were pinching themselves again in disbelief. But a lot more gently this time. They did not want to wake up this way again. Fellow Toastmasters, Sri Lankan cricketers defied the odds thanks to the analytical thinking of Aravind and Arjuna. And by using their analytical mind, they proved that they are, in fact, more intelligent than a horse or cow. How about you? Are you more intelligent than a cow? I don't want to know the answer. But in case you feel any doubt, at least now you know what you need to do. Analytical mind. Use yours. Thank you. Ooh.